Hello students, I welcome you all for costing methods and techniques class. In today's class we are going to start with your third unit, that is process costing. Okay, so before starting with the problems, first we will know what is the meaning of process. Okay, now when raw materials are converted into finished goods, it will be passing through 3 to 4 stages, so that each stage is known as process. Understanding, when the raw material is converted into finished goods, it will pass through many stages. So whatever stages it might be, so each stage is called as process. Okay, now when we maintain records process wise, it becomes a process costing. Understanding, so when we are maintaining records process wise, it is called as a process costing. Okay, like in large industries, record of each process are maintained separately. Okay, and at the end of the year, accounts are prepared process wise to find out profit or loss of each process. Okay, hope so meaning of process costing is clear. Now we will know the formula to find out cost per unit. So formula to calculate cost per unit is total cost minus realizable value of normal loss divided by input minus normal loss. Okay, now process costing procedure. Now there is a procedure. First one is, each process account is debited with all direct cost and overheads allocated to the process. The output of process is transferred to the next process in a sequence. Normal loss should be credited to process account. Abnormal loss should be credited to process account. Abnormal gain is debited to process account. Okay, now we will see what is the meaning of normal loss. Now, any loss which is arising due to normal factors like evaporation, it might be leakage, it might be. Okay, so that is called as normal loss. Now there is a treatment for normal loss as well. Okay, now first point is, normal loss is taken for calculation of cost per unit. Second one is, usually normal loss of material has some realizable value. Such realizable value should be shown on the credit side of process account. So here there are two treatments. Okay, now I have taken one small problem on process costing. Okay, I'll read out the problem. Product X is obtained from after it is passed through 3 different processes. The following is the information to process one. Okay, now to produce X, it has passed through 3 stages, that is process 1, process 2 and process 3. But here information is given only related to process 1. Okay, so 500 units at rupee 4 per unit were introduced in the process 1. The other material required for process 1 is of rupees 2600. The direct wages and production overheads are rupees 2250 each. The normal loss is 10% of input. The realizable value of normal loss is rupees 2 per unit. Okay, so this is what is the problem. They have asked us to prepare process 1 account. Even though the product has passed through 3 different stages, but as in the problem, they have given us only one process 1 information. So only process 1 account we are going to prepare. Now if they have given all 3 process information, then we will have to prepare that. And then if they have asked us to prepare finished goods account, so even that account has to be prepared. Now here we are going to concentrate only on process 1, because they have asked only process 1 and information is also related to only process 1 account. Okay, now next line, take down process 1 account. Okay, now here particulars, quantity, rate, amount. Again, particulars, quantity, rate, amount, debit and credit.
Okay, so these many columns are required. Okay, now 500 units at rupees 4 per unit were introduced in process 1. Now this is introduced in process 1. So this we are going to take it on the debit side to materials. Okay, now quantity they have told us 500 units, rate is rupees 4, okay, and the amount is 2000 rupees. Hope so everybody is understanding. So whatever raw material is being introduced, that we are going to take it on the debit side. Okay, now next is the other material required for process 1 is of rupees 2600. So other material required, so again on the debit side to other materials, okay, and the amount is 2600. Okay, the direct wages and production overheads are rupees 2250 each. So again on the debit side, as direct expenses we are going to take it on the debit side to wages okay, that is 2250. Okay, next is production overheads to production overheads, it is also 2250. Okay, yes. Now next, what information is given? The normal loss is 10% of input. Okay, the realizable value of normal loss is rupees 2. Now first we will find out how much is normal loss. Now for that, take down one working note. Normal loss is equals to, now normal loss will be always calculated on input. So input is 500 units into 10%. Okay, which is equals to 50 units. Okay, now this 50 units is having realizable value. Now realizable value is rupees 2 per unit. Okay, yes. Now realizable value of normal loss, as it is a profit for the company, so we are going to show it on the credit side of the process account. Okay, by normal loss, normal loss in bracket you can write note number 1, in bracket you can show note number 1. Okay, okay, now next, again go through the problem, if any information if they have given. We are going to record it here. Quantity is 50 units and the rate is given in the problem, that is rupees 2. So realizable value of normal loss is rupees 100. Hope so this is clear to everyone. Okay, yes. Now next, we have taken everything. Okay, now we are going to close this. Okay, obviously now debit side total is more. Okay, now first make total of quantity and then the amount, that is 9100. Okay, yes, write it here as well. 500, sorry. And the amount is 9100. Okay, now find out the balance. Here it is 450. Okay, and here this is 9000. Okay, now whatever balance we get, that has to be transferred to next process. So here you can write transfer to process to account. Transfer to process to account. Now, like whatever it is, as here they have told us like only one process account. So whatever balance here we get, that will be transferred to next process. Now now process one's output will be input for process two. Okay, then again process two's output will be input for process three. So likewise it continues. Okay, now here whatever balance we get, now this is output of process 1. Okay, now this will be transferred to process 2 as input. Okay, yes, now even make find out rate, that is 9000 divided by 450, that is 20. Okay, hope so this problem is clear to everyone. Okay, now next we are going to find out cost per unit. Okay, cost per unit. So the formula to find out cost per unit is total cost minus realizable value of normal loss divided by input minus normal loss. Okay, yes, now this is equals to, now total cost already we have calculated, that is 9100 minus realizable value of normal loss is 100. Now divided by input. Okay, so input is 500. And the normal loss is 50, right? So now simplify this. Now which will be equal to rupees 20. Okay, so cost per unit is rupees 20. Understanding everyone, hope so this problem is clear to everyone. Now there is one more concept many a problems they will give abnormal loss or abnormal gain. So what is the treatment of that we are going to see in this class itself. So next line, abnormal loss. Okay, now any loss arising due to abnormal factors is known as abnormal loss. Okay, now such a loss is over and above normal loss. Now for example, loss due to carelessness, machine breakdown, accidents, etc. Now here is a treatment for that. Abnormal loss is valued at cost per unit. Abnormal loss is recorded on the credit side of process account. Okay, now next is abnormal gain. Abnormal gain means if actual loss is less than normal loss, a gain is obtained which is called as abnormal gain. Okay, so treatment is abnormal gain is valued at cost per unit. Okay, and abnormal gain is recorded on the debit side of process account. Now for note, there are two formulas, abnormal gain or loss. How you are going to find out abnormal gain or loss? Actual output will be given in the problem. Actual output minus normal output will give you abnormal gain or loss. Next is normal output. So input minus normal loss will give you normal output. Okay. So this is what is the concept you are going to learn in your third unit, that is process costing. Now go through the problem. Okay, so go through the theory part as well and go through the problem also. Today I have taken very simple problem. In my next class we will solve like 15 mark problems. Okay, so see you in next class.